गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट यूनिट 5 डाटा हैंडलिंग। इन डेटा हैंडलिंग वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ ग्राफ्स। बिफोर डूइंग दैट लेट अस डिस्कस व्हाट इज डेटा। डेटा मींस द ऑब्जर्वेशंस, द इंफॉर्मेशन व्हिच वी कलेक्ट बाय वेरियस सर्वेस सच एज मेजरमेंट्स, मेजरमेंट ऑफ height, measurement of weight, measurement of shoe size, genders, survey responses that have been collected. There are now the types of graphs. Dear students, there are 8 main graphs. First is bar graph, second pie chart, as you can see in the figure, all are given. Third is tally marks, you all are familiar. Area graphs that you will study in higher classes. Then pictographs you have already done in your junior classes, in which you use pictures to represent the data. Waterfall graphs, linear graphs and polar graphs. Now in this chapter, dear students, very first of all you will study about the frequency distribution. This you have already done in your junior class also, 7th class also. So in frequency distribution, the data is collected in the first column. Like the data consists of these numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many times the 1 is given in the data, that we will represent by tally marks. If 1 appears for 3 times, we will put 3 standing lines and we will write the frequency as 3. If 2 appears for 5 times, we'll mark the tally marks in this way: 4 standing lines and 1 slanting line, and the frequency is 5 as it is repeating for 5 times. So in this way we will do the frequency distribution. Dear students, frequency distribution is also there in terms of class intervals. This type of data is known as grouped data, in which we do not talk about the single observation. In this, we will divide the data in classes, in class intervals. Like I have given the classes as 1 to 5, 6 to 10, 11 to 15, 16 to 20. So these are known as class intervals, and the values which lies in first interval, that is 1 to 5. In 1 to 5 interval, we will count all the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We will count all these values. If they are repeating for 7 times, we will put 7 tally marks in this way and we'll write the frequency. So this type of table is known as This type of data is known as grouped data. Now, dear students, next is bar graphs. You will study bar graphs in this chapter. The graph consisting of parallel, usual vertical bars or rectangles with length proportion. The frequency unit specified quantities occur in data. So in which we use these graphs, we use the bars to represent the information. Like here is an example for you. Types of school supplies. Like in a school, how many pencils are supplied? As you can see in the data, it is given first column, first bar represents the pencils. Second bar represents the scale. Third bar represents pen. Fourth bar represents sharpener and fifth bar represent eraser. Dear students, you should remember, while making these bars on the graph paper, the distance between each bar should be same and the height will be represented along the y-axis. This axis is along which we are representing the types of school supplies is known as x-axis, and number of supplies represented along y-axis. So in this way we will use the graph. Next, Data gives us the information. Information that we collect from various surveys. Graphical representation of data, that is like we can do a survey, we can collect the data for the number of variety of fishes displayed in an aquarium. How many types of fishes are displayed in the aquarium? We can represent the type of fishes with the help of bar graph. Another example is number of visitors of a particular age group in a musical concert. If a musical concert is there, how many people are there from 11 to 15 age group? How many people are there from 16 to 20 age group? How many of people are there from 21 to 25 age group? In this way, we can collect the data of a musical concert also. These are the practical applications, dear students, where we use the bar graph in our day-to-day life. One more example, runs made by a batsman in the last 10 one-day matches. Like MS Dhoni made how many runs in 10 matches? Like he made 800 runs. So will one bar represents MS Dhoni. That will show 800 runs. Then Virat Kohli represents how many runs he scored in 10 matches. That bar, second bar, we will show for Virat Kohli, and so on. So in all these things, we get the information, and that collection of information is known as data. Like one more example, dear students, if your teacher tells you to get the data and to represent the height of the, to collect the height of the students of your class, like height of few students you have collected, can you interpret which student has the maximum height in this data? Like you have collected the height of 10 students. Can you interpret from this which student has the maximum height of this data? No. For this, we must organize the data in the tabular form. Dear students, this form is known as tabular form. In this, we can easily judge that which student is having the maximum height. So in this, can you tell me which student is having maximum height? Yes, Stefan, 136 centimeter is having maximum height. One more, Aaron is also having highest height. So if we represent the data in tabular form, we'll easy to judge, we'll easy to interpret the data in various forms. Next, one more example, practical application where we use bar graphs in our day-to-day life, like in a restaurant. In a restaurant, like TGI Fridays, a restaurant is there. In this restaurant, the owner makes the bar graph about the dishes liked by the various people. She is Ali. She used to make the bar graph to judge which dish is liked the most and on which day. As you can see, she has made a bar graph to judge which dish is liked the most. From this bar graph, and the particular dish is liked on which particular day. On y-axis, we will represent the days. So in this way, she will prepare the dishes in her restaurant. Next is, dear students, you will study. Third is histograms in this exercise. Histograms are quite similar to bar graphs, but without the difference between two bars. In the bar graphs, as you have seen, in the bar graphs, what you have seen, we will use the bars, but with a gap. But in a histogram, we will represent the bars. We will represent the bars without the gap. And this type of histogram is only represented for grouped data. For grouped data, like 10 to 15, 15 to 20, then like this. Next, you will study in this chapter pie charts. You all are familiar with pie charts. In this, we represent the data in the circular form. A pie chart or a circle graph, we call it, is a circular chart divided into sectors. Do you know, students, what are sectors? Sectors like a piece of pizza. If you see the piece of pizza that is in this shape, that particular shape is known as sector. So pie charts are also used to represent the data. Now let's do the first exercise, dear students. 5.1 exercise. Let us discuss the questions. First question is, for which of these would you use a histogram to show the data? Dear students, histogram, I told you, is used to represent the data in grouped form. When we collect the data in grouped form, like 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 0 to 10, how many players are there who made the runs from 0 to 10, how many players are there who made the runs from 15 to 20, like this. And for the names, we use bar graphs. Like Haryana has that much COVID patients, Punjab has that much. When we use the names, we use bar graph. When we use the grouped data, we use histograms. So in first question, for which of these would you use a histogram to show the data? First is the number of letters for different areas in a postman bag. Now, dear students, areas are called by their names. And as I told you, whenever we use the names, we use bar graph. So the answer is, we will use bar graph for this information. Then second is height. The height of competitors in an athlete's meet. Dear students, height is always observed in the grouped form. Like how many athletes are there having height between 160 centimeter to 170 centimeter? How many athletes are there having height from 170 centimeter to 180 centimeter, like this? So tell me, which graph we will use to represent this information? Yes, we will use histogram, as we have to write the height in class intervals form. Third is the number cassettes produced by five companies. The number of cassettes produced by five companies. Now, dear students, as you know, companies have their names. Like T-Series has produced 500 cassettes. Sony has produced 600 cassettes. In this way, we use the name. So for this, we will use bar graph. Now, D, the number of passengers boarding trains from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. So again, we have to convert the data in class interval form. Like 7 a.m. to 8 a.m., how many passengers are there who have boarded the train? Then 8 a.m. to 9 a.m., how many passengers have boarded the train? Then 10 a.m. to 11 a.m., how many passengers have boarded the train? So in this way, we will convert this data in class interval form. So again, we will use histogram for this. Now, dear students, question number 2. The shoppers who come to a departmental store are marked as man M, woman W, boy B, and girl G. Means we are collecting this data by the names woman W, man M, boy B, girl G. So, dear students, as you know, as I told you in the first question, whenever we use the names, we use bar graphs. So we will represent this information using bar graph. But first of all, read the question. The following list gives the shoppers who came during the first hour in the morning. So the information is given to you in the questions. How many women have arrived? How many men have arrived? How many boys and how many girls have arrived? So let us count the number of women. So if you count W's in this data, you will find out there are 28 women who have arrived in this store. So we will write frequency as 28 and we will make the tally marks for 28 women. Next is count the number of M. count the number of m, we'll get 15 m. So represent 15 with the tally marks. Then count number of boys, means b, in the data. If you count, you will get 5 b in this data. 5 boys have arrived in the store. So that means you will represent it by 5 tally marks. Then number of girls, 12, represent with tally marks. Total 60 shoppers have arrived in this. So you can represent this data in the bar graph form. Why we are using bar graph? Because we have used the name W, M, B, G. We can't write them in class interval form. So that's why we will use the bar graph to represent this data. On x-axis, we will take shoppers. On y-axis, we will take number of shoppers. First shoppers category is women. How many women have arrived? Women have arrived 28. So make a bar of 28 height. Then how many men? 15. Make a bar of 5 height. Then how many boys? 5 boys. Then make a bar of 5 height. Then girls? 12 girls. Make a bar of 12 height. So in this way, you'll get the graph for this question. Now, dear students, question number 3. The weekly wages in rupees. Weekly wages means like labors, like jo mazdoor hote hain. Unhe har week ki salary alag alag milti hai. The weekly wages of 30 workers in a factory are given. So this is like first worker is getting 830 rupees. Second worker is getting 835 rupees. In this way, wages of 30 workers is given to you. Now using tally marks, make a frequency table with intervals. Now dear students, we will use class intervals 800 to 810. 810 to 820 and so on. Why we are starting with 800? Because the minimum value in this is, if you can see, the minimum value in this data is 810. So we have started from 800 810, and just see which is the maximum value. Maximum value is 898. So we'll end with 900. So in this way, we'll make 10 class intervals. First one is 800 to 810, 810 to 820, 820 to 830, in this way. Right? Then, now we will see how many workers lie in the first class. How many workers are there whose daily wages are 800 to 810. So let us see, count 810. Dear students, while counting them, keep one thing in mind. In the first class interval 800 to 810, we will not count 810 in this class. 800 is known as the lower limit. 810 is known as the upper limit. Dear students, we do not include the upper limit in the same class. So 810 will not be counted in the first class interval. We will count 810 in the second class interval. So in the first class interval, just count 800 to 809. The workers having wages from 800 to 809. So count how many are there. There are 3 workers which are getting daily weekly wages from 800 rupees to 809 rupees. Dear students, in the similar way, in the second class, the second class is from 810 to 820. But in this class, we will count from 810 to, 819. We do not count 820 in this. So we will take 810 to 819. Means jinke beech mein 1 aayega, wo sare number isme aa jayenge. 810 ki line wale. In the next class, we'll take 820. To 829. So in this way, convert them in frequency table and then make the tally marks. Now, fourth question, dear students. Draw a histogram for the frequency table made for the data in question number 3. Dear students, for this you have to make a frequency distribution table. Histogram. So in this way, make the histogram. Now the questions are there on the basis of this histogram. While making the histogram, dear students, what you have to do? While making histogram, take wages on x-axis and number of workers on y-axis. Let me show you how you can make this. This is the first question and here is second. Daily wages on x-axis and number of workers on y-axis. Now, because the starting point, this the origin point, this is the intersecting point of x and y-axis is origin. This is 0. And we are starting with 800 directly. We are taking 800. So, dear students, you have to make this zigzag line. And this zigzag line is known as kink. This is necessary to make. If the first gap is different from the remaining. See, we have taken a gap of 10 numbers in every interval. But the first gap is from 0 to 800. So, you have to make this kink. Otherwise, if you do not make it, your half marks will be deducted. So, represent that data in this form. Now, next question, dear students, on the basis of this is first question, which group has the maximum number of workers? So, just see which group has the maximum number of workers. You can check the graph. Which group is having maximum number of workers? The tallest bar is of 9. That means 832, 840. This group is having maximum number of workers. Then, how many workers earn rupees 850 and more? 850 and more. How many workers are there who earns 850 and more? So, dear students, start counting from here. 850 and more. 1 plus 3 plus 1 plus 1 plus 4. How many are there? 1 plus 3, 4 plus 1, 5 plus 1, 6 plus 4, 10. So, in this way, you will get how many workers are there? 10 workers. Next is how many workers earn less than 850? So, again, dear students, use the graph. Less than 850. For less than 850, we'll start from here. We'll count all these values. We'll count less than 850. 5 plus 9 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3. So, in this way, you'll get the answer to third part, 20 workers. Similarly, students, fifth question is given to you. The number of hours for which students of a particular class watched television is given to you. So, the graph is already given to you in the book. Just remember, along with x-axis, hours of TV watched per day, and along y-axis, number of students are given to you. Like how many students are there who watch TV for 1 to 2 hours? See, only 4 students. How many students are there who watch TV from 2 to 3 hours? 8 students. So, in this way, you can read this graph. Now, the first question. For how many hours did the maximum number of students watch TV? For how many hours maximum? So, see, tallest bar is 32. So, 4 to 5 hours. So, answer is 4 to 5 hours. Second is, how many students watched TV for less than 4 hours? So, less than 4 hours, dear students, just see. For less than 4 hours, just check out. Less than 4 hours. How many are there for less than 4 hours? So, 22 plus 8 plus 4. So, there are 34 students. Then, how many students spent more than 5 hours in watching TV? So, more than 5 means, count more than 5. 5 means 5 ke right mein dekho. 8 plus 6. That means 14 students are there who spend more than 5 hours in watching TV. So, dear students, in this way, do your questions in your notebook and make the bar graphs and histograms on the graph sheet. And you must mention the scale on y-axis how many workers are represented in this way. So now thank you and have a nice day.